Let's dissect this episode like a frog. It's great that this episode starts with students randomly sucking on limes. Gives it no context until later. It's like so many kids aren't worried about how sour they are, and they all can just handle it. Like, usually there's less people that can handle it than that. Then Eugene is in Manny's locker, of course, because he loves her. Not only is he being creepy, he knows her locker number as well to get inside of that thing. He makes a lime pun with subline, which means awesome. It is an awesome pun, but it's not awesome that he's at her locker. Not at all. Then Mindy's Flo comes out of nowhere and runs other kids over, with Mindy not even caring. Mindy mentioned that they are bowing when they are really just getting run over. I don't know how she's going to win after that. Then she just goes through the door and some of the surrounding doorway. Okay, and then the principal's right there. He doesn't even, like, put a stop to it. I'm like, okay, that's how you want to run your school. Just make it relax. Hey, holes in walls, no problem. When did Billy get such a big book bag? I thought he was stupid. And he didn't even take any books home with him at all. Poor Grim had to carry the textbook history of textbooks. Meanwhile, Mandy hides in the bushes, weirdly, and asks Grim and Billy if she's pretty and if she should join a beauty pageant. They laugh out loud at that. So no, they don't think those things. In fact, they laugh a whole day about it. Wow. You know, as soon as they learn that Mandy was trying to be trash-talking Mindy, they take Mandy's side as Billy tells Mindy that she'll take her pants off, which he meant beat your pants off, which sounds more violent to me. Just kidding. Mandy gets help from the beauty guru of the underworld. It shows she was even grumpy inside her mom's stomach. Wow, Mandy. She is told by the guru that she has to smile or there's no hope of winning the pageant. By the way, that bird character is legendary. I'd love to have that guy be a part of my videos and just direct them nice and smoothly. Grim and Billy tried gags to make Mandy smile, like filling Billy's mouth with helium and flying around. They even tried singing to her with bars, rhymes. Well, it seemed like Mandy was having none of that shenanigans because she's a more, like, how do I say it, someone that doesn't have a sense of humor. Maybe like a twisted sense of humor, but that's about it. The pageant was full of insecure moms that were putting the kids in the pageant for their own sake. Nice commentary on show moms, of course. Not everyone is like that, but still, there's a good chunk that are like that. Mandy got so mad that Billy said Mandy looked a lot better, so she punched his nose off when she had a bag over her head, so that's why. Then Grim does it later to poor Billy again. He just can't keep his nose on. The pageant begins with lemons and limes shot at the audience. Here, have a snack, guys. And how it ends is Mandy actually smiles after a minute. Then reality falls apart and some crazy stuff happens with Billy, Grimm, and Mandy. Especially at the end when they become the Powerpuff Girls. Let's agree that Mandy never smiles again. Never, ever, ever, ever. It was a funny episode. I think it's one of the best, maybe besides Fred Burger. He got stuck in the freezer that one episode. Anything with Fred Burger for me is a more enjoyable, but this was actually like really insane and crazy. So I grew up watching this show, and I had a neighbor that reminded me a bit of Mandy, like just how bossy she was. And plus the name I go by in real life is Billy, so like of course I was gonna check into the show. It has some great dark humor that you didn't really notice too much as a kid. It helped you grow into some dark humor. I definitely did. If you want to watch some more videos, here they are. Leave a like if you enjoyed and subscribe if you're new. And this is Cartoon Central, where cartoons are meant for. Thank you for watching. Appreciate you guys. Peace.